We already made a video on thorn and eth, two of the forgotten letters of the alphabet, but there are still more parts of Old English that were also forgotten. Well, the first one isn't so forgotten, it's still on our keyboards, the only one out of our list that is on the standard QWERTY layout. Introducing ampersand, a corruption of and per se and. Yes, that's the etymology. Wait, that's part of the alphabet? Isn't it just a symbol? Well, yes, but it actually used to be part of the alphabet and was the 27th letter. It was used exactly the same as now, shorthand for the word and. You might have already known that, so let's move on to something more forgotten, that not a lot of you will recognize. Yogh is our second letter, and is very similar, visually, to a 3. This letter was used for the sounds g, y, w, and h, but is now replaced by a digraph, just like thorn and eth. Wynn was a precursor to the letter W, and eng was like the digraph ng. But let's ask the same question that we did for thorn and eth. Should we bring them back? Well, I think the conclusion is the same as before. If we wanted, we could try to bring them back, but it'll take a while before everyone catches on. Ah, with these new, old letters, our keyboards can't be 3x3 cubes anymore. Wait, 31 is a prime number. Shoot, keyboards can't be anything, let alone a cube.